if wings are flying to the air, it magnifies the crazy height. But when we are creating our position profile and safely sit on G4 and trying to sort of, you know, create threats in the right position, Knight C3, C6, Queen C2, again, so it's like by the bishop. Also, and play that bishop cannot come there. So, yeah, why is it that like to move D5 or something was just to like jump on axis, and white is trying to swing the axis really quickly. But black can find it play G7, which is what the end of the H3 to D6 way. So, I took double the 20 in the square, so that the queen can't go there. H3 is my queen now, so you'll ask, but now ready, you guys can ask, how many in this game? H3 seems to be a bit of a stupid move. So as you know, bishop has 5, pawn takes on 5, pawn takes on 5, the queen is in the f5, you know what I'm saying? After g4, you know, bishop pawn is missing in f5, so f5 is being good, like 4 pieces on the board. Then f5 square is beautifully contested, and I like to think that in each game, there is one specific square which is being contested by the player.
Want that square because it's an important center for power and for control.
So, bishop f5 anyway. Keep your rank queen, and the queen slides to b3, playing the b7 pawn. The probably may like to make it to the queen b6, which he does. g4 being played, keep like you're trying to keep out the bishop, so that again, white wants that fx point. This is why we can play.
In order to prime for g4,
play g4 and take out the bishop. But Ding takes the queen, because the bishop is hanging. A takes b3, having a double pawn aisle, but in exchange of this double pawn aisle, double pawns, so there's always a give and take. You are losing, the double pawns, but you are gaining this L5 access which you are having right here, and it's, you know,
crushing.
If he gets too much access on the A5, that's waiting, doesn't want that A5 access, but more than that, the whole bishop play which happened, that is to be resolved. It's regarding the whole attack made by Ding to claim that
c3. See guys, what Kokesh wants is
he wants this knight. He's saying, yeah, he can take my pawn, but I can go ahead and take a knight, damage his structure. The rook b8 is going to look ugly. So, you know, h5 is being played, trying to, you know, same thing. So rook g4, people also g1 being played, sort of, you know, like,
don't let them take too much control, as
inevitably I want to be on g4, the rook has to be fully positioned on g4, in order to penetrate, so that defense is this way. Next thing is g4, as we saw, the black rook having an eye on the h3 pawn. Next thing is g4, you know, and you know what I think, the beauty about h3 g4 is, the bishop,
because after
rook a3 or something, you're not really getting anywhere. So, if you see here as to why, if you see earlier in this, as to why bishop takes c3 could not have been killed, as you can see the rating doesn't slightly in favor of British, maybe because of the that's not really good.
Yeah, so
I mean, because of these complications, it's not good for black to take the pawn on. Maybe it's a poison pawn. So either way, that whole thing happens, and sorry, I meant too much. Right. So as you can see, this pawn is blocked by the bishop.
Yeah.
This place cannot go because this square can be occupied by the knight.
Was not contested, but now is because of the g4
pawn. So it's like the bishop can only go. It has E6. Slowly.